that we should not take sides in this war by becoming a combatant. And we have held firmly to that position, and we plan to continue to hold firmly to that position.
By the time U.S. Secretary of Defense William Perry testified before Congress in June of 1995 that the U.S. was not taking sides in the Yugoslav conflict, a full range of secret military assistance operations to the Croatian government and Bosnian Muslim forces were already underway. At a remote airfield high in the mountains of the Croatian island of Brač, American intelligence operatives assembled the unmanned aviation vehicles, known as UAVs, for reconnaissance, while Croatian soldiers guarded the airport gates.
It was known within the UAV community who they were and where they were flying. When you suddenly ran into roadblocks and couldn't get information anymore, you knew it was the Tier 1 CIA guys that were operating. You could look at truck traffic, you could identify the types of artillery, the types of tanks, their movement. With this kind of information, you could literally analyze to extremely small detail the tactical capability of a force.
Only 1 month before Defense Secretary William Perry testified that the U.S. was not taking sides, a predominantly Serbian civilian area, supposedly under U.N. protection, was suddenly attacked by Croatian forces. Several U.N. soldiers were killed in what turned out to be a massacre of the Serbian civilian population of Sector West. Thousands of Serbian refugees fled across the Sava River from Croatia into northern Bosnia. Croatian sources put the number of Serbs killed in the attack at 1,000. Serbian Orthodox Church officials stated that 5,000 civilians were killed. But there was no criticism of this atrocity by American officials, including the killing of UN soldiers, because the U.S. was deeply involved in assisting the Croatian military. Efforts by British and French representatives on the UN Security Council to place sanctions against Croatia were repeatedly blocked by America's UN representative, Madeleine Albright.